gravitational force.
Yeah, very good. So, good morning, sir. Let us resume our class where we left yesterday. Yesterday we had discussed about gravitational force and its properties. So, can anybody tell me the properties of gravitational force that we had discussed yesterday? Anyone?
Yes.
Yes, Shubham, please proceed.
Sir, first property is it is always attractive in nature.
Yes, very good.
The second property is it obeys the inverse square law of distance.
What is meant by this?
It means that force of gravitational is inversely proportional to the square of distance between the two masses.
Well done. Very good, Shubham. That means you are paying attention in the class. Very much. Very good. I'm very happy. Good. Yes, Shubham. Continue.
And the third one is gravitational force is conservation in nature.
What is meant by conservative nature of a force? Please tell me.
Sir, it means that when a object travels from a distance from A to B, when we throw again to B to A, then the net force is become zero.
Net work done by the force is zero, Shubham. Net work done by the force is zero.
Okay, sir.
Net work done by force is zero, then the force is said to be conservative. Okay.
Okay, sir.
And the
fourth property is gravitational force is independent of the medium placed between masses.
Medium placed between masses. Very good. Any other?
And this, sir, fifth one is gravitational force is a weak force.
Very good. Gravitational force is a weak force. Well done. Very good, Shubham. Well. Now, Smriti Gupta, what is the value of gravitational constant, universal gravitational constant, and by what letter is it denoted? Yes, this Smriti Gupta, please answer. These children, they never answer any question. Okay, Chinmay, please you answer. Chinmay, what is the value of universal gravitational constant? Yes, Chinmay.
May I?
Chinmay, where is Chinmay? Okay, Tejas, please you tell. Tejas?
Sir, 6.67 into 10 to the power minus 11 Newton m square upon kg square.
Very good. 6.67 into 10 to the power of minus 11 Newton meter square per kg square. Okay. Tejas, is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Oh. Now, today, I am going to prove that why gravitational force is said to be a weak force. Okay? So, we will take two masses of 1 kg each. We will take two masses of 1 kg each and they will be placed at a distance of 1 meter. And then let us calculate the value of gravitational force between these two masses. And then we will find out the magnitude of the gravitational force. And then we will have an idea about the strength of the gravitational force acting between the masses of 1 kg each, separated by a distance 1 meter. Okay? Okay, children? Let us see.
Magnitude of gravitational force, that is,
magnitude of gravitational force. Okay. See, please pay attention. Let us find out the gravitational force between two masses of 1 kg each, separated by 1 meter distance. Okay, children, what we are going to do is we are going to find out the value of gravitational force acting between the two masses of 1 kg each, which are separated by a distance of 1 meter. Okay, children? Nobody is responding.
Okay, sir.
Please write down the statement, and then we know that these are the two masses, suppose 1 kg, and this is also 1 kg. And what is the distance between the two? It is?
Okay, sir.
It is? Tell me. This is M1, this is M2. So, F gravitation, we all know that G, M1, M2, upon R square. Okay, here M1 and M2 is equal to 1 kg and R is equal to 1 meter. Okay, children? So let us put the values. Putting the values, we will get and G. And value of G, you all know what is the value of G? What is the value of G?
9.8 meters.
6.67
into 10 to the power of -11
meters square. Chinmay, you are talking about small g, acceleration due to gravity. It is 9.8 meter per second square. Yesterday I told you the difference between capital G and small g. Still you are not knowing the difference between capital G and small g. You are getting confused. Chinmay, now is it clear? Chinmay Nirvan. See now. Let us put the value and let us find out there is some force acting between these masses. Okay. Fg is equal to 6.67 into 10 to the power of -11 into 1 upon 1 square. Okay, children. So what is the value of gravitational force acting between two masses of 1 kg and separated by a distance of 1 meter? We get Fg is equal to 6.67 into 10 to the power of -11 newton. And when we say 6.67 into 10 to the power of -11 newton, -11 itself is a very small unit, isn't it? Isn't it, children? Children, are you understanding? It is
yes,
a very
sir.
Small unit. That means Fg, if we write like this, so 0.00000000001234567891011667 So this is the value of gravitational force which is acting between the two masses of 1 kg each. Understand it, children, or not?
Yes.
This is why we do not experience the attraction of bodies, because the magnitude of gravitational force acting between the masses is very less. Magnitude बहुत छोटा है ना, इसलिए उनके बीच में attraction feel नहीं होता है. समझ में आया कि नहीं?
Yes, sir.
But all the objects, they attract all other objects with a force which is equal to gravitational force, and it is proportional to the product of the masses and is inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. Okay, but listen, I have shown you this, the magnitude of gravitational force is very less. It is of the order of 10 to the power of -11 newton. Okay, so that is why the magnitude is very low, so the effect of force cannot be felt. Effect of force cannot be felt. Are you getting my point or not?
Yes, sir.
Write down. Please pay attention. The magnitude of gravitational force. Magnitude of gravitational force is very less. Gravitational force is very less. Gravitational force is very less. Is very less. That's why its impact is not felt. Okay? Suppose you are standing and your friend is also standing at some distance. You are exerting force on your friend and your friend is exerting force on you. But none of you feel that my friend is attracting me or your friend is attracting you. Understand? So, because of the very less value of gravitational force. Are you getting my point or not?
Yes, sir.
Is it proved that the gravitational force is a weaker force? Is it proved now?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
It is therefore proved that gravitational force is a weak force. Gravitational force is a weak force. Gravitational force is a weak force. Okay, children? Now, have you noted share at the board now?
Yes, sir.
Very good.
Okay. Please note down.
Sir, can you please down the camera? Sir, last line is not visible.
Last line, I'm reading it out for you. The magnitude of gravitational force is very less. That's why its impact is not felt. It is therefore proved that gravitational force is a weak force. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Now completed.
Shall I write the code now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, after gravitational force, which force we are supposed to study about? Tell me.
Magnetic.
Hello. Yes, sir. Tell me.
Electrostatic force.
Yeah, electrostatic force. Very good. So let us write down about electrostatic force. Okay? The electrostatic force. First of all, let me tell you about charge. Do you know what is charge? Charge is the motion of protons. What are protons? Protons are the fundamental particles inside the atom. And what are atoms? Atoms are the final particles that make up the matter. In our surroundings. All the matter in the universe is made up of tiny particles called atoms. And inside the atom, there are electrons, protons, and neutrons. Okay, children?
Okay,
yes, sir.
And motion of charge constitute electric current. Motion of charge constitute electric current. Okay, children?
Okay, sir.
motion of charge constitute electric current. Now let us write about electrostatic force. Electrostatic force. This is also very, very important, and then we will differentiate between electrostatic force and gravitational force, and we will also find out the similarities between electrostatic force and gravitational force. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now, okay. Who is asking? Please ask what you want to ask, sir. Yes, sir. Please ask. What is your doubt? If anyone has any doubt, please ask. Karishma, do you have any problem? Karishma Meghwal?
No, sir.
Okay. Now see, let us see what is electrostatic force. Suppose this is a charge, point charge Q. This is a point charge Q. Okay? Q1 this is. And this is another point charge Q2. And they are separated by a distance of, suppose, R. Okay, children? एक पॉइंट चार्ज है Q1 है, एक पॉइंट चार्ज है Q2. Can you see the point charges? Can you see the point charges or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Given the names Q1 and Q2, and they are separated by a distance R. They are separated by a distance R. Okay. Now let us the force of electrostatic, we will express it in the form of FE से हम लोग इसको denote करेंगे, ठीक है बेटा? जैसे gravitational force को FG से denote किया था ना, किया था कि नहीं?
Yes sir.
FE से denote करेंगे, and it is found that, please pay attention, FE is proportional to Q1 into Q2. Q1 into Q2. Are you getting my point or not?
Yes, sir.
Electrostatic force is proportional to the product of the magnitude of the two charges. Okay, sir. And it is also found that FE is proportional to 1 upon r square. Okay, children?
Yes, sir.
So, can you find out any similarity between gravitational force and electrostatic force? Yes, children, tell me. Yes, Shubham, can you find any similarity up to here where we have written the dependency of electrostatic force on the product of charges and on the distance between them? Shubham, please tell me, Shubham.
Yes, Shubham, sir.
Can you find any similarity between gravitational force and electrostatic force up to now?
No, sir.
No? Okay. Anyone? Karishma Meghwal? Did you find any similarity between gravitational force and electrostatic force till now? Bolo? Karishma, Tejas Chaudhary, please tell. Tejas Chaudhary? Yes, very good. Tejas Chaudhary has told the correct answer, that both of them, they are inversely proportional to the square of the distance. Can't you see, Shubham Kumar? Can't you see, Karishma Meghwal? Can't you see, Shubham?
Sir, there is a network issue.
Yes?
Sir, actually, sir, there is a network issue, sir. So the sir, there is a network issue. So the board is blurred. That's why I can't see.
Now, can you see?
Yes, sir. I can connect it to the internet.
Now, listen. Now, can you see the difference between gravitational force and electrostatic force till now?
Yes, sir.
Shubham, what is the difference? Yes, what is the difference?
Sir, they both are inversely proportional to 1 upon r square.
Very good. So, both of them, they obey the inverse square law of distance up to now. Ye hume pata chal gaya. Pata chal gaya ki nahi?
Yes,
when we join these two, when we remove the proportionality, when we remove the sign of proportionality, one K is introduced, proportionality constant, okay? A1, K2 upon R square. A1, K2 upon R square. Okay? This is electrostatic force. Q1, Q2 upon R square. Where K is proportionality constant, K is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught, and its value is 9 into 10 to the power of 12 Newton meter square per Coulomb square. ये समझ में आया कि नहीं आया ये बताओ. यूनिट ऑफ चार्ज इज कूलम. व्हाट इज द यूनिट ऑफ चार्ज सिग्नल?
कूलम.
आई थिंक यू आर नॉट अंडरस्टैंडिंग चिल्ड्रन. आर यू? व्हाट इज द यूनिट ऑफ चार्ज चिल्ड्रन?
कूलम.
करिश्मा, कैन यू स्पीक? व्हाट इज द यूनिट ऑफ चार्ज?
कूलम.
कूलम. यस.
मैं कूलम.
Listen, you just try to compare the proportionality constant in gravitational force, it was capital G, and it is equal to 6.67 into 10 to the power of minus 11 Newton meter square per kg square, and here the proportionality constant K is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught, and its value is 9 into 10 to the power of 12 Newton meter square per Coulomb square. So now you can compare the value of proportionality constant in gravitational force and electrostatic force. So which constant is having more value? Is it in the gravitational force? Okay. So that is why we will come to the conclusion that electrostatic force is a stronger force. Okay. Have you noted this or not? Understood or not?
Sir, what is written after Newton M square upon?
Upon Coulomb square. C-O-U-L-O-M-B. Coulomb square. Coulomb square. Okay? Coulomb is the SI unit of charge. Samajh mein aaya ki nahi aaya? Now I am writing the electrostatic force. The electrostatic force is the force which acts between two point charges separated by some distance. Okay, children. Any problem?
No.
Now, one thing more. Since we know that charges are of two types, positive charge and negative charge, so electrostatic force is attractive when the charges are of opposite nature, when the charges are of opposite nature, that means positive charge and negative charge, they will attract each other, okay? And similar charges repel each other. Similar charges repel each other. Okay, children? This is also one of the differences between gravitational force and electrostatic force. Gravitational force is always attractive in nature, while electrostatic force may be attractive or repulsive depending upon the nature of the charges. Are you able to find the differences or not?
Yes, sir.
Please write down. Electrostatic force may be attractive or repulsive depending upon the nature of the charges. Similar charges. Positive, or negative. Attract while dissimilar charges means positive, negative, attract each other. ये बात समझ में आ गई कि नहीं आ गई? आ गई कि नहीं आई?
Yes, sir.
Have you noted this?
Yes, sir. Noted.
Have you noted this?
No, sir.
Note down. Note down. And then we will move on to some more properties of electrostatic force.
Sir, after positive and negative, sir, repel should come now in the board.
What?
Just see. Sir, after negative and negative.
Yes. Please correct. Similar charges repel. Similar charges repel. While dissimilar charges, positive and negative, attract each other. Now, is it okay, Shubham?
Yes, sir.
So, everyone has to be attentive. What is written and what I am speaking, okay? You have to be attentive. Please note down, children, everyone, so that we can move ahead.
Noted, sir.
Okay. Everyone has noted or not?
No, sir. Please wait 2 minutes.
Yeah, I'm waiting. Now, shall I this portion of the board? This portion, shall I run?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
What is the SI unit of charge, student? Can you tell me what is the SI unit of charge? Yes, Tejas Chaudhary. Tejas Chaudhary, what is the SI unit of charge?
Sir, follow.
Coulomb. Write down. You can write in your notebook SI unit of charge is coulomb. Unit of charge is coulomb. C-O-U-L-O-M-B, coulomb, C. Okay? लिख लो गाइड के ऊपर. Now shall I write the board completely? Shall I write the board completely or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Up next, we are here discussing the properties of electrostatic force of attraction or repulsion. Electrostatic force may be attractive or repulsive depending upon the nature of the charges. Second, electrostatic force also obeys the inverse square law of distance. ये दिख रहा है ना according to the formula. Then third one, let us write down, please pay attention, properties of electrostatic force. The electrostatic force depends upon the medium placed between the charges, between the point charges placed between the point charges. Now what is meant by this? See, suppose these are Q1, Q2 and they are separated by a distance R here, and this is air, suppose. This is air here. This is air, okay? So electrostatic force will be something, suppose F E air. F E air, okay? Now if the medium placed between these two point charges is changed and it is suppose these are the two point charges and they are separated by distance R, and suppose this is coil, then F E is equal to F E coil at this temperature. Now F E air is not equal to F E coil. Do you understand the difference between the gravitational force and electrostatic force? Electrostatic force depends upon the medium placed between the point charges, whereas gravitational force do not depend upon the medium placed between the masses. Okay, are you able to recall, children?
Yes, sir.
Please write down. The electrostatic force depends upon the medium placed between the point charges. If the medium is changed, the electrostatic force also changes. The electrostatic force also changes. Okay?
Okay, sir.
If the medium between the charges is changed, the electrostatic force between them also changes. The electrostatic force between them also changes. Please write down, and how it changes, I have shown here. Please draw and write. Have you wrote it, children?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Sir,
okay, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now see, at the end, we will tabulate the similarities between the electrostatic force and gravitational force, and we will also tabulate the differences. So I will ask you only, that what is the difference and what is the similarity. Okay, children, so be careful. Listen carefully, note carefully, and if at all you have any doubt, please ask. Okay, children?
Okay, sir.
At the end, I will ask you only the differences and similarities among the two types of forces. Okay? Can anybody tell me why gravitational force is always attractive? Why it is not repulsive? Bolo. Yes, Karishma, please tell. Karishma, may God tell why gravitational force is always attractive. Why is gravitational force always attractive? Karishma, please tell. Anybody? Anybody from? Anybody can tell why gravitational force is always attractive? Yes, Tejas, please tell. Yes, Kartikeyan, can you tell? My question is, Tejas Chaudhary, why is gravitational force always attractive? Why it is not repulsive? Why it cannot be repulsive?
The gravitational force is always attractive based on the traditional understanding matter of which the positive mass.
Yes, very good, Chinmay, very good. Listen, masses are always positive. They can never be negative. So, since masses are always positive, so the force of gravitation is always attractive. On the other hand, charges can be positive also and negative also. So if positive charge interacts with the negative charge, it is attracting. And if negative charge interacts with the negative charge or positive charge interacts with the positive charge, then the result is repulsive. Okay, children?
Okay, sir.
Mass is always positive, so it is always attractive in nature. Next property. Electrostatic force is a strong force. How? Let us check. Suppose we take a point charge Q, it is 1 coulomb, and another charge, point charge Q2, it is 1 coulomb, and they are separated by distance 1 meter. Now let us find out the electrostatic force. If they are both are positive charge, then what will be the resultant? Whether they will attract or repel?
They will repel.
Very good. So force will be K into 1 into 1 upon 1 square. Okay, children, are you understanding or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Will be K. And what is the value of K in case of electrostatic force? What is the value of K? Please tell me.
So 1 upon 4 pi.
No, value I'm asking. 1 upon 4 pi. That is different. What is the value? Magnitude.
9, 10 to the power 12 Newton m square upon Coulomb square.
So it is 9 into 10 to the power of 12 Newton. This is the force acting between two point charges of 1 coulomb each. So can you think of the magnitude? 9 into 10 to the power of 12. 9 into 10 to the power of 12. Aari baat samajh mein ki nahi aa rahi?
Yes, sir.
Now you can think that why electrostatic force of this strong force, because it is of the order of 10 to the power of 12 Newton. Are you baat aa rahi hai samme?
Yes sir.
Okay.
Sir,
it is a strong force, yes, you know, 9 into 10 to the power of 12 Newton. Okay. So these are the properties of electrostatic force. Now let us write down the similarities and differences between gravitational force and electrostatic force. First of all, we will write the similarities. Shall I write the board? Shall I write?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now let us write down the similarities among gravitational force and electrostatic force. Let us write down the similarities. Similarities among. Similarities among gravitational and electrostatic force. Gravitational and electrostatic force. Gravitational and electrostatic force. Okay. So you are only going to tell me, Chinmay, please tell me one similarity among gravitational force and electrostatic force. Bolo jaldi Chinmay, speak quickly.
Sir, both act in vacuum. Both are central and conservative. Both obey the inverse square law.
देखो पहला पॉइंट बोथ आर कंजर्वेटिव फोर्सेस. कंजर्वेटिव फोर्सेस का मतलब समझ में आ रहा है ना आपको? शुभम कुमार एज टोल्ड इन द बिगनिंग व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ कंजर्वेटिव फोर्स. ओके, ऑल ऑफ यू नो और नॉट?
यस सर.
सेकंड Shubham, can you tell me similarities among gravitational force and electrostatic force? Please tell me. Yes, Karishma, tell. Karishma, you tell. Karishma, tell please. Karishma. Okay. Kushad, can you speak? Kushad Soyal.
Audible?
Yeah, you are audible now. Speak if you want.
Both obey an inverse square law.
Very good. Both obey inverse square law of distance. Inverse square law of distance. Karishma, can you tell me one more similarity among these forces? करिश्मा, और कोई सिमिलरिटी है इनके बेटा?
सर, दे प्रोपगेट विद फाइनाइट स्पीड.
करिश्मा, आई कैन नॉट हियर यू, प्लीज स्पीक लाउडर.
सर, बोथ एक्ट इन अ वैक्यूम.
ठीक है, लेकिन देखो बेटा, ओके, एनी अदर? Now I'm going to bind up the class. If you all of you please, it is an assignment for everyone. If you can add more similarities among gravitational force and electrostatic force, that you have to add, and also you have to write down differences.
Sir,
you have to write down the differences between gravitational force and electrostatic force in your notebook and in the
sir, one more similarity there.
Now please keep quiet. In the next class, I will ask, you have to note down in your notebooks. Okay, children?
Sir, both act in a vacuum.
Aljia Bano, I am not asking now. You have to note down in your notebooks. Okay? Okay, children? Will you do or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
You have to write down in your notebook if you can add more slackies, and also you have to make two columns. In one you will write gravitational force and the other you will write electricity force, and you will write their corresponding differences. Will you do that or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. And in the next class I will ask. Okay, children?
Yes, sir.
Okay, sir.
If you have any doubt regarding what we have studied today, please ask if you have any doubt.
No, sir, no doubt.
You don't have any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay, so we can end up the class.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you and have a nice day, children.